Hi, I want to go ahead and help you a little bit with your studies, and I want you to turn to page 70 of your hematology book. So I'll give you a moment to do that. Okay, I want to talk about hemoglobin structure and function. It's really important you understand hemoglobin synthesis, because when you get farther into your studies, if something's going wrong with hemoglobin synthesis, you're going to have an anemia, and it's a problem. So make sure you know that normal hemoglobin production is dependent on these three processes. The first is the adequate iron delivery and supply. The second is adequate synthesis of protoporphyrins. And protoporphyrins are a precursor of heme. And the third one is adequate globin synthesis. I also want you to understand that iron in the ferric state, so iron in the ferric state is delivered to the membrane of the red blood cell and is carried there by a protein called transferrin. The iron is inserted into the protoporphyrin ring to form heme. So what happens is the ferric iron is reduced to ferrous. So it comes into the cell as ferric, and then it's reduced to ferrous, and it's inserted into the protoporphyrin ring, and that forms heme. Any of the excess iron that's in that red cell is going to attach itself to ferritin, and ferritin stores that iron. So 2/3 of the total body iron supply is bound to heme in the hemoglobin molecule. And then I want you to go ahead and turn to page 72 of your book, and we're going to talk a little bit about the globin chain synthesis. If you look at that figure 312, you'll see that there's some embryonic globins that we're not really worried about right now, is the epsilon and zeta. They're gone before you're even born. If you notice up there, that yellow line, that gamma, there's a lot in the fetus, and it slowly declines to really nothing by the time an infant is a year old. On the other hand, look at that beta, that green. It's got that B there. That's the beta chain or globin. There's really nothing in the fetus, and it keeps getting higher and higher, reaches its highest level once an infant reaches a year. So while the gamma is decreasing, the beta is increasing. Then you've got your alpha. If you notice, the alpha is very quickly formed in the fetus, and it stays in a pretty steady, constant state. That's important to know because that helps you understand the adult normal hemoglobin levels. Okay? And adult, normal adult hemoglobins, they're formed as tetramers, consisting of two alpha chains. Remember that alpha chain, there's the most of that, and it's pretty constant and pretty steady in an adult, from fetus to adult. So it consists of two of the alpha chains and two non-alpha globin chains, okay? So two alpha chains plus two chains that aren't alpha. And normal adult red blood cells contain the following types of hemoglobin. 95 to 90% is hemoglobin A, and that consists of the alpha and beta chains. 2 to 3% of the hemoglobin is hemoglobin A2, which consists of alpha and delta chains, so two alpha and two delta chains. And going back to that figure 312, you can see the delta, it starts at birth, and there's not a lot of it, but it stays pretty steady. It goes up a little bit, but it's a low level. So only 2 to 3% is going to be that hemoglobin A2. And 1 to 2% of the hemoglobin will be hemoglobin F. That's called fetal hemoglobin because, as you can see in the fetus, that gamma is really high. You have a lot more of that, and then that steadily declines. By the time you're an adult, only 1 to 2% of hemoglobin should be hemoglobin F. And that's composed of the two alpha and the two gamma chains. So understand that in hemoglobin, you're going to have your heme. You're also going to have your globin, hemoglobin. So make sure you understand that. And there's two parts to that. If you have a problem with the heme part, you're going to have a problem. If you have a problem with the globins, you're going to have a problem. And both of those will cause an anemia.